All right, let's get started with Talos and a Kubernetes cluster running locally on your machine in Docker. This is the easiest way just to try out Talos, see what the API is like. So first thing we're gonna do is just go ahead and install Talos Control. And to do that, we can use Sidero Labs tap, which has Talos Control. This can keep everything up to date. Brew works on macOS and Linux. So FYI, in case you never knew, I've been using it on Linux for probably 5 years now, and it's great. So you can run Talos Control cluster creates, which will create you a default cluster with two containers running locally in Docker. One is gonna be your control plane and one is gonna be your API server. And I'm gonna go ahead and add a couple more workers to this and say we'll get 3 total workers, which will give me 4 total Docker containers running. Like I said, one is gonna be the API server and the other ones are gonna be worker nodes with the kubelet. Now this is best considered like a development cluster, something to test things with, especially with Talos Control and Talos if you want to test out different machine configs or see what the API does. But this isn't like a highly available run this in production sort of thing. It's not available outside of your node. It's going to use local 10.5 addresses by defaults that you can just route to see what the API is like. And because Talos is just an API in front of basically a kubelet in container D, it makes all your interactions with it really easy, where you don't need to script things, you don't need to shell into it and look for bash. There's no bash there to look into. And in just a few minutes, it prints out all the details about the cluster that was created. I can see I have a Docker provisioner, the name of the network and cluster, as well as all of my nodes, again, Docker containers that are running. So if we do a real quick Docker PS, we can see all of the nodes here, Docker worker 1, 2, and 3, as well as the control plane. Now, one thing it also spit out was where it stored my kubeconfig, but I have something that I always like to do with my kubeconfig, and that's like not use that file. If I look at the file, it's actually a symbolic link to dev null. I don't want anyone writing to that file. I save all my kubeconfigs separately. So let's go ahead and get the kubeconfig out of the cluster in case we need it or we want to put it somewhere else. And in this case, I'm going to run the Talos Control kubeconfig command. I'm going to say where I want to run it, which is just a different location in the kube folder, as well as the node that I'm pulling it from. And this node is the control plane node. The 1050 or 10502 is the first node of my cluster, and it printed out before that that's my control plane node. I can only get the kubeconfig from that cluster. So if we save it out, I already had a file there, but we just went ahead and overwrote it. And let's export it real quick. And now I can see my nodes. Those are the nodes that I'm now pointing at the kube control or the Kubernetes API server running on this control plane, and I can see all of those nodes. So we definitely know we have a Kubernetes cluster running. Let's look at Talos Control again. One of my favorite commands is the dashboard command, and this opens up a TUI with a dashboard, which is what you would normally get if you install this on bare metal. You'll see something like this, which has the state of different components as well as the main logs coming out of the system. And you can scroll through these logs. You can't do anything. The dashboard is meant to just be a read-only interface to these things, but it's really cool to have this available on different nodes. We can also check things out like the service command, which is going to show me all the main services that are running on the machine. So if I run service and my node endpoints, again, this is the control plane, but I can also do this for other nodes. You can see the control plane's running etcd as well as this trustd, which is allowing the other machines to join the cluster. So a little difference there on how a control plane node versus a worker node looks. One last little thing that I think is really cool about the Talos API is the way it allows you to debug things. So if we actually run the Talos Control pcap command and then a network interface and what node we want to look at, this is going to stream basically a TCP dump from that node over the API to my terminal. And I can look at what's happening on the network as well as filtering and everything else. I can store and save a pcap file. And those are super handy for doing things like debugging even on a minimal OS. So last thing we want to do is go ahead and destroy the cluster, which is just Talos cluster destroy. It's going to delete all of those nodes and the network interface, and we're back to normal. Playing with Talos locally is great because you get to see how some of this works, and it's a really easy way to get onboarded. But if you actually want to install it on a bare metal or a VM, check out some of our other videos and we'll show you how to get started with that too.